It's the Andy Snowden Radio Show. 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 Yes, indeed, this is the Stage and Screen Show with me, Andy Snowden, here on 105 Calon FM. Right, let's do this, shall we? Now, earlier this week, Theatr Clwyd released its itinerary for the coming months up at the Theatr on the Hill. It's rather extensive, so I'll give you a few dates for your diary in a moment. Grab yourself a pen and something to write on. But it's going to start with this one, this coming weekend, Friday and Saturday, the 4th and 5th of February. It's the brilliant Welsh in the West End live, and I'm thrilled to say I'm joined by the creator and cast member, quickly taking time off from rehearsals to speak to us, Steffan Hughes. How are you, my friend?
Hi, good, thank you. How are you, Andy? You okay?
I'm very well, mate. Thanks for speaking to us at short notice.
Hey, no worries.
Now, the story behind Welsh of the West End, it's quite a remarkable one, really. Set up during lockdown, all online. Now you're out there putting the shows on live. Back at Theatr Clwyd, it's an amazing story. Go on, tell us about it.
Yeah, and you know, it's so lovely to be back at Theatr Clwyd. Welsh of the West End as a group, we're a group of Welsh musical theatre singers, as the name suggests. But we kind of formed in March 2020 when the first lockdown happened. We were all sat at home, you know, and all these amazing singers who had been doing 8 shows a week all of a sudden had nothing, you know, and were sat at home. So I thought, well, this is the perfect chance. Let's get together to create an online virtual performance. And yeah, that's what we did. And it really grew from strength to strength from there, really. And Theatr Clwyd were, fair play to them, the first place to give us that real life in-person stage back in 2020. And then we were back the last year in 2021, again on the outdoor stage. So they've been so kind to us. And yeah, we're really excited to be back next week, the 4th and 5th of Feb, indoors this time at Theatr Clwyd. So we really can't wait.
But the Welsh are renowned for being great singers. So to have Welsh West End stars, that's pretty much the cream of the crop.
Oh, I agree. I'm just spoiled for choice. There are so many amazing Welsh performers doing so well in the musical and theatre industry, you know, and not only on the West End, you know, in theatres across Britain and beyond. As you say, there's something about us, the Welsh. We love a sing song. We love a bit of harmony. So I'm sure that's helped so many people along the years in their auditions. Maybe those casting directors just hear Welsh and they assume, okay, hopefully we'll have a bit of standard and a bit of quality here. So yeah, it's amazing to kind of shine a light maybe on those amazing young singers who are doing so well. That's been really fun to do.
So there's four of you. There's yourself, Mared Williams, Luke McCall and Sophie Evans. Are they?
Yes.
Were you all friends before? Did you just ring mates and say, how about killing a bit of time? How does it work?
Well, I'd worked with them all individually and knew some better than others. Mared Williams, for example, I was in high school with her in St Asaph.
Right.
So myself and Mared have known each other for a very long time, and she's in Les Mis at the moment. So very excited to be bringing her with me. Luke McCall then, who is a very successful name already at such a young age. He's also in Les Mis. He's from Bala originally. And I believe he was the youngest man ever to play both the Phantom and Jean Valjean on the West End. So he made a name for himself very quickly, fair play to him. Yeah. And then Sophie Evans then. So I'd done a few concerts with Sophie before Welsh of the West End, but of course Sophie's known for starring in Wizard of Oz, and she was on that Search for Dorothy all those years ago with Andrew Lloyd Webber, and she's just finishing her time at Wicked. So she's playing Glinda the Good Witch on the West End in Wicked. So she'll be finishing this weekend right now, and then she'll be joining us in Theatr Clwyd next weekend. So she's fresh off the West End, and I believe it's her first time at Theatr Clwyd. Fingers crossed, I think that's right. So I'm quite excited to be bringing her up to Mould as well.
It's a phenomenal cast, really, when you put it like that. Was being a performer for you, was that always on the cards as a kid?
Yeah, do you know what? I think it was. I was super lucky. My singing teacher was also my primary school teacher, Leah Owen, and she taught Mared Williams and many, many others in the area. And she kind of snapped us up really early and gave us so many opportunities. We started competing in the Eisteddfod and did so many concerts. And again, as you say, Wales, we're so lucky as young singers to have these opportunities every weekend. There's either a singing competition or a village hall concert or whatever for us to gain confidence. So yeah, from very early on, I always wanted to be a singer. I didn't know at that point if it was going to be something that I could achieve, you know, because being a full-time singer and performer, it's a tough lifestyle, but I consider myself really, really lucky and really fortunate to work with these singers as well, because I've always been a big musical theatre fan, so to get to share the stage with them now, it is a real honour for me.
Yeah, and as you said earlier, you conceived the idea of Welsh in the West End during lockdown, and you put a video out, and the weird thing is, when I was doing a bit of research about you earlier, and I thought, I can remember this happening, because you put out a video of you doing Seasons of Love from Rent.
That's the one,
and,
yeah.
You know, I don't know if you remember during lockdown one, but everybody was sending everybody videos, whether they were funny or they were just something of a family doing something. And yours fell into my inbox and somebody said, have a look at this. And I listened to it and I just thought, that is phenomenal. But the thing that's always amaze me about those videos is how you can put them together, because I mean, everybody sounds like they're all in a studio, but some of them are in the bathroom, some of them are in the kitchen, basically in a house saying, everyone be quiet, I'm singing now. Is that the truth?
Yeah, do you know what, it was a bit of a trial and error process at the start. I think by now we've managed to kind of hone in on the process, but none of us really knew what we were doing at the start, and as you say, people were recording from their bathrooms and their living rooms and having to wait for the dog to stop barking or mum and dad to be out the room, and it was very much a trial and error and a bit of a jigsaw, and yeah, as I said, we pieced it together. I'm quite fortunate. I worked a few years in television as a researcher and did some producing, and so I kind of sat in some rooms with some editors and so on and got a flavor of that type of work. So I was always feeling up for it and thought, let me give this a go. And yeah, as you say, that first video, Seasons of Love, maybe it was the song as well, and the words are so amazing about how do we measure our life, you know, when everything else falls down, it's our loved ones and family and friends that are still there for us. So I think it was a combination of everything and the right timing as well. People seem to really love that video, and it got shared far and wide. So I was so impressed and felt very grateful to everybody.
But it went viral. It was.
It did. Yeah, it got a million views in the first few days, really. And I think at that point we knew, right, we're going to have to carry this on now. We've got no choice. We're going to have to keep going. So we did. We picked nice songs that we thought represented us well, but also, you know, again, as I mentioned, with the lyrics, nice, beautiful lyrics. And yeah, we kept working, and about a year and a half in, we're still producing, and we've managed to support some charities and worthy causes along the way as well. And I think for me as well, it's been really special to be able to provide a little bit of work for singers, musicians, editors in a time where we were going through so many restrictions that work just wasn't out there. So that was a really special feeling for me as well, just to give the people the project to work on. It's been really special. But yeah, I'm working kind of tirelessly in the background to try my best to make Welsh at the West End a success, because I love working on it so much and these singers are so talented. But yeah, starting with next weekend, 4th and 5th at Theatr Clwyd, it will just be a night at the musicals, as you'd expect, your favourites, your classics from all the musicals you know, and a few contemporaries chucked in there too, and a few Welsh language musical theatre as well. So fingers crossed, there'll be something for everyone.
Lovely. Steffan, it's a treat to speak to you, my friend. Thanks ever so much for that. I really appreciate it.
Thank you for having me.
Marvellous. And all the best here, and all the best for the rest of the year.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
Cheers. Steffan Hughes of the Welsh of the West End Company, this Friday and Saturday, the 4th and the 5th of February, up at Theatr Clwyd. Get your tickets now.
Your town, your station, your voice. Afternoons on Calon FM. Listen online at calon.fm.